Vedic timeline, we don't have any history or any information between this 1.7 million the year to 5000 year, right? So that gap is very huge, and we don't have any history or any Purana which talks what happened in between that period.
Yes, I also thought about the same thing. What happens between Ramayana and Mahabharata?
Of course, they are two different yugas. So one yuga...
But there should still be some information. But surprisingly, it's not there. Chances are some of those texts have been burnt in the invasion of the Muslims. So we just don't have that information. What can we do? Surprisingly, Mahabharata, Bhagavad Gita are well preserved. Ramayana, which is very old, is well preserved. Upanishads and Puranas are well preserved. But what happens in that big window, nobody knows. I mean, no modern person knows. Of course, Supreme Lord knows, Devatas know, but we don't know. Right? And maybe there is something. If we do a sufficient archaeological excavations, we may find something. Like right now, BRC India, Bhaktivedanta Research Center, has digitized 20,000 books of literature, Vedic literature from Bengal and Bangladesh. So maybe somewhere more information is hidden. We don't know. See, right now, we only haven't even scratched the tip of the iceberg. Right? We know a little bit of Bhagavad Gita. We know a little bit Ramayana. And there is a big black box there. There are so many literatures. Who's going to analyze them? Who's going to study and decipher and present it for the modern society? Right? So, for example, if you go to Jiva Goswami Sandarbhas, Paramatma Sandarbha, Krishna Sandarbha, like that. There's so much information, but you know, we haven't really gone deep. And believe it or not, I was reading in Christian tradition also, there are 2,000 books other than the Bible, which are not being uncovered. They found these in ancient locations within Italy, Spain, in Middle East. Nobody wants to open them up. Nobody wants to study them, interpret them. Some people consciously don't want it to come out. They just want some simple Bible and just move on with our industrial civilization. Because most people think that this is all unnecessary, right? We just want people to work hard, run the economy. That's what the leaders, modern leaders want. If you talk too much about God, they'll say, oh, this fellow is a troublemaker, fire him. Because he may cause trouble to us.
So Prabhu, they even covered, Jesus serving in Jagannath's temple as well. Srila Prabhupada has once said Jesus was serving in Jagannath's temple. They even covered that so that not everyone can know about it.
They don't want to reveal that information that Jesus spent a good bit of, like something around 20 years he spent in India. They don't want to reveal that at all. They want it to be like a Middle Eastern, Western religion. But he himself was a yogi. And where do yogis go? To learn. They go to banks of Ganga River to learn, or they go to Himalayas. Yeah. So there is a lot, because, you know, even in our office, right, if you talk too much about religion, they'll say, why are you talking about that? Right? They want people to just work hard, drink alcohol in the night, and forget everything. That's how these modern economies run. If everybody starts questioning their origin, you are not the body, you are the soul, then the current industrial complex will collapse. So they don't want it. Even this, they will allow only to a certain extent. As long as you are still working hard in the companies and making money for the economy and paying your taxes. They won't allow even devotional activity if it is, you know, destroying the economy. Yeah. Reality. Anything else? Yeah, something for us to research. Like go to brcindia.com and see how many books are there. Just reading the titles, it will take you 3 months. You don't have to open the book, just reading the titles. A long way to go.